Hey, Talent Display Thursday, take 3.
Love, peace, and blessings, my beautiful people. Hey, 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 this is your girl, Sky.
And I'm Cree.
And this is...
Shira.
And this is the Cree and Sky Show.
Yes, this is the Cree and Sky Show. Yeah.
Yes, welcome back to all my lovely subscribers. We love you so much.
Welcome. Yes.
Happy Black History Month. But you know what today is, right?
Before you know what today is, what I would like for you to do for me, please, is hit the subscription button. Subscribe. You can just do it one time. You don't have to do it 3 times. Thank you very much. And can you please hit the notification so you can hear that ding, 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 ding. When things come from the Cree and Sky Show. Thank you very much.
Yes.
Now, what you say today? Today is Talent Display Thursday. Okay, Talent Display Thursday. Okay, Talent Display Thursday.
Yes, on today's Talent Display Thursday, we have our lovely Shira.
Thank you for having me.
Yes, welcome. So, how did you start this whole lovely Gift Geisha thing?
Well, Gift Geisha came out of necessity.
Okay.
Basically, I was looking for a gifting company to do it for me because I was sending gifts to friends that were out of state or overseas.
Okay.
But it got to be a little cumbersome and trying to find boxes and all that sort of stuff to fit. So after I did a little research, I found that none of the companies were what I wanted. Not for my kind of friends. Okay. My friends want glitz, glam, some color, flowers, something fun.
Okay.
And so I ended up being my own solution.
Okay, that's cool. So how did you come up with the name Gift Geisha?
Well, okay. I sat down with a friend. Y'all know Ashley.
Yay, Dash.
Hey, Dash.
Shout out.
And I shared with her the concept. And basically she just said that we needed it to be short, it needed to be catchy, and it definitely needed to include the word gift so that it's very clear about what I'm offering. And then the word geisha came along because I was on the metro about a week later Googling words to start with the letter G. And geisha came out.
Okay.
I thought it was cute and I did a little research and I just went with it because geisha is a multifaceted intellectual woman and I felt like that was definitely what Gift Geisha is. Gift Geisha offers you gifts for celebratory, mm-hmm. birthdays and weddings, right?
Okay.
But then we also do congratulatory, which is graduation and new homes.
Okay.
Say thanks for buying a new house.
Yes.
And then we can do something on the softer side, which is for sympathy and offering condolences.
Okay.
So.
Okay, that's pretty cool and thoughtful. Everything. Like, oh my goodness.
She's worth
everything.
That's so sweet.
So.
All right, so what I would like to know, you know, on your website, because I have shopped there before.
Yes.
Wonderful.
Yes. Helping black businesses. Black business.
Because it's Black History Month.
Yeah,
making history over here.
Over here. All right. So what I would like to know is, on there, there was something about domestic violence awareness. I seen like a box or you donating something. Can you elaborate on that for me, please?
Yes, of course. So... Gift Geisha is associated with domestic violence awareness because my mom, she was a victim of domestic violence dispute. So my way of giving back to that cause is coming up with creative ways that my customers and my friends can donate to the organization. And the one in particular I use is Turnaround Inc., which is located in Baltimore.
Okay.
They offer support and counseling services. So Gift Geisha doesn't give financially, like we don't just donate money and say, you know, here's the money, bye. We kind of looked at it more so, what is it that the women aren't receiving? Because they get so much from Turnaround Inc. They get support, counseling, informational links, just things to get them back to self. So while you're so busy, or they're so busy doing that for themselves, how about they get a gift? A surprise.
Yeah.
It doesn't have to always be during Domestic Violence Month. It doesn't have to be around the holidays. So for us, it was more about and more important to do something spontaneous.
Okay.
And so I come up with creative ways to do that.
Which is so good because the holidays.
Okay. People always give, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I had 4 young ladies who wanted to remain anonymous, but through their donations, I was able to come up with 7 Pamper Me gifts for Valentine's Day.
Okay, that's awesome. Yes. Clap it up for the four anonymous. Thank you, Miss Anonymous.
Thank you.
That is awesome. That is good stuff.
That's really dope. Good stuff. Like, wow.
Yes.
To even come up with that whole concept of awareness for domestic violence is awesome, because a lot of people keep that to themselves and they don't really express how they feel, and they're like shut in. And to have somebody box some gifts and things like that and prepare it so lovely and beautiful, I know it just brightens up their day.
Yes. That's a beautiful thing, like she said. Here, one more question for you, ma'am. I would like to know, where do you see yourself in your business in about 5 years? Five years.
Hard question.
Yes.
I would say definitely still smiling and happy dancing. That's because I stumbled upon Gift Geisha, but I realized it was my happy space. It's my break from work. It's my break from friends and family. It's my break from home ownership. It's basically a space that I call my own, that I can go into and just listen to music, rock out, and be creative and find joy if I'm missing it that day, or if I just want to give it to others. And I know that with growth, Gift Geisha can be even more awesome and can be shared with others, but I don't want to grow too fast. I don't want to become so consumed with Gift Geisha that it's no longer fun. Mm-hmm. So I do see growth, like a team of three in the next 5 years. Also being able to do more pop-up shops so that there are more pickup locations.
Okay.
And just adding more local businesses and brands to the gift box. So of course it includes things like scarves and candles and wraps and like selfie props and stuff like that.
Ooh.
But I also have added services.
Ooh, yes. What kind of services?
Well, I did my first partnership with a beauty service brand that I will be revealing for Valentine's Day.
Ooh, yes, right? Stay tuned. Mm-hmm. That's why you gotta follow, like, and subscribe.
Like, and subscribe.
And, well, do it too on your guys' page, but also on Instagram.
Yes. We're gonna ask for that information in a minute.
Yes, we'll be displaying her Insta,
where you can find that good stuff from.
Yes. Also, we'd like to see some of your props or something.
Yeah, I think you have a nice little box.
Oh yeah, did bring a Valentine's Day box.
Yes.
I'm so mesmerized by y'all.
She is simple, y'all.
Oh, this is beautiful. So, look at this. I'll hold it. Yeah, definitely. Guys.
This is my Valentine's Day collection. And our gift boxes are typically gold. They say Gift Geisha and has pretty flowers on the outside. However, for Valentine's Day, I decided to do limited edition boxes with hearts and love. And they're like see-through. And they're keepsake boxes. So when you gift it to your Valentine, they can have it.
Yes.
It includes a card, so we already write the message for you. It has champagne inside, it has a candle and a mirror compact, and then we also added the option to get Victoria's Secret gift cards or Bath & Body Works gift cards. You can select the amount on the website. We make it really easy. This isn't the only box, but this one runs for $41. There's so many other options for Valentine's Day on the website, but the whole point is to bring gifting services straight to you. You don't have to shop for the card. You don't have to shop for all the items that go in the box. You don't have to buy the box. You don't have to buy the ribbon. You don't have to do anything.
You don't have to do anything, guys. Guys, you don't have to do anything. Do you hear that?
Nothing. I do it for you, including the gift bag and tissue paper. You just need to book an appointment to pick up your gift.
Yes. So thank you so much, Gift Geisha, for coming.
Wait, one more thing. Before you leave, can you tell us the difference about the picking up and the delivery? Did we talk about that?
Oh yeah, because that is a big misconception.
Yeah, okay. Yes. We need to know about the picking up and delivery thing.
Well, so I don't want anyone to get confused. Gift Geisha does not do delivery. What I do is two options. Of course, you go online, you purchase. We can ship it directly to your giftee, to whether they're in state or out of state. But we know that you also might want to pick up your gift and take it to the party with you. So I offer a pickup option, not delivery, just a pickup. And the location is at the MGM Grand Lobby Hotel.
Okay. Well, thank you for that.
Well lit. Thank you for that. Good stuff.
Yes, well lit. Protect yourself. Now, before you get out of here, can you let the people know where to find this stuff, or where to get the Gift Geisha stuff, where to get the Valentine's Day stuff, where to get the stuff, where to donate, where to buy the stuff, what to do? Let them know.
Yes. Thank you so much. Okay. All right. Let's talk slow then, right?
Okay.
So, Gift Geisha is on Instagram. Mm-hmm. It is at Gift Geisha, and Geisha is G-E-I-S-H-A. All right. And then you can also go to the website, which is thegiftgeisha.com. Okay. But then more importantly, you can follow me, because I tell you everything that's going on anyway, and I really would prefer my customers get to know me when they shop with us, so that you know what you're getting. It's very rare that you meet the owner of the company, and so I just want to share the exchange. You can send me a DM and tell me what kind of gifts you like, what your mom might like, her favorite color, and we can go from there, or send me an email. But on Instagram, you can find me at shy underscore everything. So it's C-H-Y underscore everything.
Yes. Oh my goodness. Do you hear? It's a knock. I hear a knock. Yeah. Somebody's coming. Hold on.
Let me see who that is.
Oh my goodness. Who's coming? They must be coming for these gifts and stuff like that.
Goodness, but we're so happy that you came. Thank you so much again. Shout out for coming. Oh my God.
Oh
my goodness.
Look at who it is.
Dang!
Okay. Want to touch.
Welcome.
Yes.
Want to touch. Okay, we got her here for Talent Display Thursday. Okay, Talent Display Thursday.
Hey.
All right. Thank you so much for walking into this lovely talent display Thursday. You just walk right on in, girl.
Thanks for having me.
So what is your talent?
So my talent is massage therapy. It has gone from the household to now worldwide. Mm-hmm. And I'm providing services to any and everyone.
Okay. That's cool. That's good talent. All right. So when did you decide that you wanted to become a massage therapist? And when did you decide you wanted to make that like your entrepreneurship?
First question, when did I decide to become a massage therapist?
Yes.
After growing up massaging my mother, I realized how massage therapy can actually heal.
Okay.
I'm not into too many medications and everything like that, so I looked at massage therapy along with drinking tea and different herbal things as a way of just naturally healing the body without putting all these pills and everything into your system and affecting different organs.
Cool. That's what's up.
All right.
I like teas.
You did ask a second question. You did say when I decided to have massage therapy as an entrepreneurship, right?
Yes.
When I was working a 9-to-5, I realized that this wasn't me. I couldn't see myself retiring under somebody else's belt all my life. So I decided to say, you know what? I have a gift. Why not use it? So I decided to spread my wings and fly.
Okay, that's so cool. So how did you come up with your name?
Actually, a client. While massaging a client, she asked me how long have I been doing this. And when I mentioned to her that I was doing it since teenage years, basically, she was like, so you were born to do it. And it resonated with me and it stuck with me. And honestly, I wish I still had her information to give her a call and tell her thank you.
Yeah, that's cool. That was nice.
Yeah.
That's what's up.
Thank you.
And you took
the client.
Like,
yes. Thanks to
awesome.
You.
Thank you. Yeah. So I got a question for you here. Is it important to get a massage, and what are the benefits of it?
Definitely. Anybody and every body, literally the word body, should be receiving a massage. Massages are definitely beneficial to stress, tension, headaches, any lower back pain that you may have. It can also help lower blood pressure.
Oh.
It can help you to sleep better, promote range of motion. Anyone with fibromyalgia, any chronic issues, neck pain, and many more things of health purposes.
Okay.
I need one now. Right now. How often do you recommend people get massage?
Monthly. Massage therapy is actually recommended on a monthly basis. Now, you can choose to do weekly or bi-weekly, just depending on your issues. You may be somebody that is dealing with some type of diagnosis, such as fibromyalgia, which is a pain that you have every day, all day long, throughout your body and your muscles. So somebody like that, can benefit to have a massage on a weekly basis.
Okay. So what's the difference between a masseuse and a massage therapist?
Good question. A masseuse has basically resonated with people. It has a unsavory representation, actually. Masseuse is more so somebody that does massages like out of a parlor, whereas massage therapists, we appreciate the term therapist, and we're more worried about the health and well-being of our clients.
Okay, that's a good way of putting it. So, okay. No happy endings on your end.
Correct.
Gotcha. Okay. That's the difference, the main difference.
Yes.
We kind of got scolded, but we know the difference.
Okay. So, is this like your 9-to-5 or you like quit? When did you quit your other 9-to-5 to do something you were passionate about in your whole business?
The funny thing is I didn't quit.
Oh.
I got fired.
Oh.
But the blessing about it is I asked God to show me a sign, and that was it.
Okay.
And when he showed me that sign, that's when I got up and was like, let me continue doing what I was doing. Because I was already doing massage therapy on a part-time basis.
Okay.
But in order for you to receive full-time clientele or full-time attention from what you're trying to do, you have to put your full-time in as well. So I did it full-time and now I'm here.
Okay. All right, what tips do you give someone who is thinking about leaving their full-time job to be a professional therapist?
Even if you're not a therapist, just wanting to be an entrepreneur doing your own thing, honestly, I'm a very spiritual person, so I walk by faith, not by sight. If you were to walk by sight, you would think that you're not able to even do half of the things that, you know, you want to do. But walking by faith means just literally leaving it up to God and speaking into the universe, into existence, and surrounding yourself with individuals that want to see you grow.
Okay.
Because not everyone is in the same mindset. So I say do it. Anybody, honestly, I say do it. It's your happy place. It's a peace of mind. It's joy.
Okay.
And you will always, always be okay.
Okay.
You will always be okay. I like that. I like that.
Yes. Yes.
Talk about
what did you say, sweetheart? And I love your sweater. This is so cute. Is that for sale? Do you have apparel for Born to Touch?
At the moment, I don't, unfortunately. Okay. Maybe in the future, that'll be a gift that I can give to my clients as a thank you and to promote me as well.
Okay. So where can we find you and like, how can we get in contact with you? Stuff like that, with your gifts.
Well, the good thing about my service is it's actually mobile. Really quickly, I want to just state to you how I went mobile was because I realized it's beneficial to adults, people with kids, people that elderly that may not want to leave home, anything that I can provide service to you and you be comfortable. That's what it's all about. So I decided to do mobile.
That's cool.
But I do have two locations that you can also come and see me, which is in Greenbelt, Maryland, and also in Northeast DC.
Yes, I want y'all to know that we've visited the place in DC, and she actually came to the house for my birthday, for her birthday.
Yes.
We use the service, just letting you know.
She is
the
bomb. Oh my God, I love her.
And I have a little bit more information. Okay. So with my business as a thank you to all of my clients, I have a program where it's Refer 3 Massage on Me.
Ooh.
So after your third referral, after they show up, I give you a free Swedish massage.
Y'all better tell everybody, tell your mother, tell your father, tell your sister, tell your brother, tell
your cousins, everybody. Your uncles.
Try to get the free massages.
Get the free massages. Oh my God.
Okay.
So what's your Facebook, your IG, what else? Snapchat, everything.
Okay, so majority of my social media name, as far as my social media on Instagram, Born to Touch Therapy.
Okay.
And my email address is borntotouchtherapy@yahoo.com as well.
Okay. But since we're here and we're talking about all these beautiful, bold, and black women,
yes,
we wanted to just drop a nugget about Madam C.J. Walker. Did you guys know that she was the first American, Afro-American, self-made millionaire in America?
No, I didn't know that.
Yes. And she made her own hair care product for all the Black African women so we could slay these edges, you know
edgies.
What I mean? Yes. So if you guys want to know more about Madam T.J. Walker, I suggest you go look her up because she's an awesome woman. And thank you for tuning into our channel.
Before we leave, I would like to leave y'all with this note. Don't aspire to make a living. Aspire to make a difference. And that's from Denzel Washington.
Thank you so much, guys. Thank you so much for coming.
You're welcome.
Oh, my God. Going to the test. You guys, don't be shy. Call her. She comes to you. Heated.
Valentine's Day. Yes. Get the massage things going. You got the gifts.
All you
got
to do is call me.
Everything. We have one-stop shop. If you need pictures taken, you KreeEntertainment.com.
Makeup.
We can do it. All the packages. Shop it up. One-stop shop. Everything you need. Oh, my goodness. Yes. Look at that. I'm on this show on the road.
Yes.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you all.
Thank you. God bless.
Love you.